Hi Club One members, Parinaaz here. The topic for this month's discussion is hypo hacks. So this is a topic which most of us would be well aware of, as almost all of us would have experienced some kind of hypos throughout our diabetic lifespan. So I feel the first step to tackling hypos would be something very basic, that is to understand your symptoms. So there would be some symptoms which you would experience regularly while you have your hypos. Once over a period of time you understand what those symptoms are, you can take preemptive actions before you, the moment you start experiencing those hypo symptoms. And of course, there would be times that your hypos could be symptomless. And in such a case, regularly monitoring your sugars, whether it is on your meter or via a sensor, really helps. So I recently got the sensor, and I feel it certainly helps to give you an idea of where your sugars are headed, whether up or down, and then you can take preventive actions if you see that it's falling. Secondly, always carry your hypo stash, that is your glucometer tabs or your sugar sachets, whatever works for you, and keep them at your workplace, keep them at your gym or your school, wherever you are. Like for me, where I work currently, my boss actually keeps a bottle or two of glucometer tabs, and whenever my colleagues feel that I'm talking strangely or sweating profusely, they will give me a few of those to correct me. Which proves the point I was making last month, that is, you should always let your colleagues at work know that you are type 1. Thirdly, don't overdo things. In your zeal to have normal sugars, you might want to over bolus, over exercise, or maybe even starve yourself. Don't do that. I guess all of you are smart enough to not do that anyways, but I thought I'd mention it anyways. And that's it for me for hypo hacks, but I would just like to end with an incident that happened with me many years back. I was at work. I had taken my pre-lunch shot, and still to have lunch, and there happened to be some event at work due to which I forgot to eat, and ended up having a really severe hypo. So that's what I would like to say. If you haven't actually fallen off your chair laughing already, don't forget to eat. If you think you are going to be busy, then just don't take your insulin shot. So that's it for me and hypo hacks. So if you have a similar funny story to share about your hypos, please let us know so that I don't feel like the only fool around here. Thanks a lot. Bye.